a little bit with the background of the so-called angels of death. Pastor Apollo Cubiloy, the self-proclaimed appointed son of God, has used the term angels of death to threaten the members who violates the doctrine, teachings, and code of secrecy of KOGC. Thus, the angels of death was established in 1990. Apollo Cubiloy handpicked trusted members with background in military and security training to compose the Angels of Death, which later on utilized as liquidation team to various KOGC locations nationwide. Members reportedly possess firearms and are supervised by Crescente Chavez Canada, or also known as Enteng, and Ingrid Canada. So you might be smiling right now, but later I will prove it to you in the succeeding slides. These angels of death reportedly operate as a secretive, loyal group within the KOGC ministry, capable of imposing both physical and psychological harm on those who do not comply with Cubiloy's wishes. The very name, angels of death, suggests a level of intimidation and power that goes beyond mere spiritual guidance. The allegations paint a picture of an organization that functions as a private army, a weaponized wing of Cubiloy's church used to coerce and control members, particularly vulnerable young women whom Cubiloy has allegedly abused. On the part of the investigation, as the primary investigation office of Philippine National Police, and in behalf of my director of the Criminal Investigation and Detection Group, we have set some objectives pertaining to the very existence, whether or not the angels of death does exist or not. So we established some objectives to prove whether or not angels of death exist. Second, reinvestigate dismissed cases involving deaths by members of Angels of Death. Third, identify the crimes perpetrated by the alleged Angels of Death and its surrounding circumstances. Fourth, identify the degree of participation of members and provide evidence for filing of appropriate charges in court. Definitely, we have to find evidence so that we can file a complaint before the court. As to the efforts that is being undertaken by the CIDG in particular and the PNP in general, we are continuously identifying the alleged members of Angels of Death, profiling of the alleged members, interview of victims' family, relatives, and witnesses relative to the crimes perpetrated by the alleged Angels of Death, thorough and discreet validation on the involvement of the alleged angels of death relative to the death of former KOGC members, coordination with other intelligence units, the local police, the AFP, counterparts, and other agencies for case build-up and possible operations if evidence warrants. And next is continuous monitoring and gathering of information and submission of development report as obtained. Now, ma'am, I would like to bring your attention to the diagram being shown in this slide. We would like to show you how is the flow of instruction being undertaken. Of course, as we all know, that the KOGC is a structured organization, but this one, it is not an structured organization. Kaya yung angels of death, ma'am, is the term that is being used. But it is not an organization. It is how, in this diagram, how the instruction is being relayed or being followed by the members. Well, of course, on the right corner, as you can see, is Pastor Apollo Cubiloy. Based on that diagram, Madam Chairman, there are four na kanyang pinagkakatiwalaan ng kanyang mga instruction. Si Mr. B, of course, Mr. Crescente Canada, si Ingrid Canada, at saka si Pastor Acobo. based on the diagram. Yan ma'am yung apat na mga pinagkakatiwalaan niya. As of now, base doon sa mga nakukuha nating mga interviews and affidavits na nakuha natin. So yan ang lumalabas sa sa ating structure. Now ma'am, in relation to the punishments being undertaken on some deaths also, but we are not saying that they are the perpetrators. That's why, on the words of our director, we are on case build-up. We have to gather evidence so that we can prove the objectives that we wanted, to prove the whatever crimes that was committed. Those are the circumstances. To explain further, ma'am, the diagram. If you see on the diagram, ma'am, most of the instructions is coming from Ingrid Canada. However, if you look into the diagram, dotted lines po siya, ma'am. So meaning, she gives the instruction. However, they need confirmation from Crescente Canada. That is why there is a solid line coming from Crescente Canada. So hindi pwedeng si Ingrid lamang po yung magbibigay ng instruction at siya lang din po yung susundin. So manggagaling iko-confirm din po nung mga 1 to 12 na yan and more kay Crescente Canada. Yan po yung usually nangyayari. As what we are saying, ma'am, these are all taken, extracted from the accounts of our witnesses and taken from their affidavits. Hindi ito imbento. All others, ma'am, yung mga nandyan, ma'am, yung mga nakapula po dyan, ma'am, if you look into that, so yan ma'am yung mga ongoing investigation po natin, yung mga tinakpan po natin na ABC, yan ay mga witnesses po natin ma'am, and with indulgence of the committee, Madam Chairman, since this is an ongoing investigation and we're looking into some evidence, before we can file a case before the court of law, yan po lang muna yung maipapakita natin sa ngayon ma'am.
Maraming salamat para doon, Colonel Liquid.
Thank you, ma'am.
Oh, just a couple of follow-up questions kung pwede na rin sagutin. Una po, sa tingin nyo ba tuloy-tuloy pa yung trafficking operations ng KOJC? General Torre.
Based on our assessment, ma'am, yes. There's still a possibility, although not on the same scale as when Kibuloy is still heading the operations, and with this kind of publicity that the good senator is doing, I believe that this will have a great impact in stopping this illegal activity, ma'am.
Sana nga po, General. Salamat. At yes. Lastly, at this point in time, sino ang new leader? May impormasyon ba kayo kung sinong lumilitaw na bagong head pastor?
As of the moment, ma'am, based on that link diagram, ma'am, you can see there on the upper right corner, Mr. Marlon Acobo. He has been doing that role ever since we were there. And I would like to clarify that among the informants that were covered in that link diagram are people that you actually heard a while ago, ma'am. So those people there are prominently, the people that we heard a while ago are prominently playing a role in that link diagram.
Maraming salamat para doon, General Torre at Colonel Marantan at Colonel Liquid.